आर्टिकल 370 एंड एब्रोगेशन ऑफ आर्टिकल 370 द टेकिंग अवे ऑफ स्पेशल स्टेटस ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड नाउ द सुप्रीम कोर्ट्स जजमेंट ऑन द एब्रोगेशन ऑफ आर्टिकल 370 इज मेकिंग ऑल द हेडलाइंस एंड द जजमेंट हैज ऑलरेडी बीन डिस्कस्ड बाय द रितु मैम सो वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द अदर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ इट टुडे. Hello and welcome to the in-depth series section of Drishti IAS. I am Aisha Singh and in today's video we will be talking about the Article 370 and its SR Bommai judgment connection. So why is it that whenever the Article 370 is being talked about, there is one judgment which is frequently in news, and that is the SR Bommai judgment. First of all, about the points of discussion, we'll be looking at the SR Bommai versus Union of India case. About its background, why is it so significant? About the verdict of the Supreme Court, what is the reference of Kashmir with regard to the SR Bommai and versus Union of India case, and in the end means practice question. Topic is of relevance from General Studies paper 2, that is Polity section. Specifically important from the mains perspective, as whenever you are writing a point and an answer in Polity section, you need to write about the judgments and the names of the judgment. So the news talks about what was the S.R. Bommai judgment which the Supreme Court relied on in its Article 370 ruling. So first of all, who was S.R. Bommai? So S.R. Bommai was the Chief Minister of Karnataka. So there was a case regarding S.R. Bommai judgment, and Supreme Court has relied while giving the judgment about Article 370 on the S.R. Bommai judgment. So while upholding the abrogation of Article 370, which the Honorable Supreme Court has done in its verdict, that upholding of abrogation of Article 370, that Supreme Court has supported it. And the Supreme Court has relied heavily on its landmark 1994 judgment in S.R. Bommai versus Union of India. So there was a reference which the Supreme Court made while giving or while upholding the abrogation of Article 370 about the S.R. Bommai versus Union of India. So now, first of all, what is S.R. Bommai versus Union of India case, which happened in the year 1994? So S.R. Bommai was the Chief Minister of Karnataka. I'll just be telling you about the background of this case also, what happened. So first of all, let us know that what is S.R. Bommai versus Union of India case. So it was first, this case first went to the High Court, but High Court rejected it, and then it went to the Supreme Court, and Supreme Court then referred it to the 9-judge bench. So the 9-judge bench of the Supreme Court interpreted Article 356. Now what is Article 356? So there are three types of emergencies which we talk about in our country and is given in the Constitution. First is Article 352 in normal terms, which we talk about is national emergency. Even though the term national emergency is not been given in the Constitution, but the name with which it is majorly and basically known to people is national emergency. Then Article 356 is about President's rule, and Article 360 is about financial emergency. So 356 is about President's rule. So the 9-judge bench of the Supreme Court interpreted Article 356, that is the President's rule, to define the contours of proclamation of President's rule. So this 9-judge bench actually talked about that what are the basis of the President's rule, then how and why and when the President's rule can come into the picture, and what can be the guidelines of issuing the President's rule. Then Article 356 talks about that in case of the failure of constitutional machinery in a state. Now this is the term which is given in the Constitution. The term President's rule is not given in the Constitution. It is given that in case of failure of constitutional machinery in state, then the President's rule can be issued in a state. So if the state's constitutional machinery is not working properly, then the president's rule can apply on the state. And the court ruled that the president's decision would be subjected to judicial review. And whatever decision the president takes with regard to the president's rule, the decision and the actions of the decision. See, president, Article 356 is about president's rule. Let us know about few of the things of Article 356. It comes under the Constitution under Article 356. It needs to be approved by both the houses of the Parliament, that is the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, and it has to be done within 2 months. Within 2 months, and the maximum time period for which it can go is 3 years. And in one go, it can go on for 6 months. And after every 6 months, it needs to be approved by the Parliament. Parliament means both the houses of the Parliament, that is the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. And President has the power that whenever the President deems fit, the President can remove the President's rule. So, this is few of the important features of Article 356. So, the court ruled that the president's decision would be subject to judicial review. Now, when president thinks that the constitutional machinery in a state is failing, then the president rule gets applied. Now, the actions on the basis of which the president has taken decision, like what are the actions on the basis of which the president has taken decision, comes under judicial review. So, judicial review, if the actions are malified, if the actions are irrelevant, if the actions do not have any sufficient base, then it can be nullified also, because this comes under judicial review. So, the president's decision would be subject to judicial review. This was one of the very major decisions which was taken under the SR Bommai versus Union of India case. Now, about the background of the SR Bommai versus Union of India case, that why did this point comes into the picture. So, in 1989, what happened was that SR Bommai was the chief minister of the state of Karnataka. Now, what happened was that the center dismissed Janata Dal led Karnataka government by imposing president's rule. So, there were many things which were going on, and the governor thought that the SR Bommai government will not be able to work now. So, what happened was that the center dismissed his government and imposed president's rule there. So, the then Karnataka governor recommended to the president that he take over the state's administration. So, the governor also was of the opinion that the state, the constitutional machinery in the state has failed and the president needs to take over the working. And the governor gave two reasons for it. First, Bommai did not command a majority. Majority in the house needs to be there. So, at that point of time, SR Bommai did not have the majority. And then, no other political party was in a position to form the government. So, in this case, the governor recommended the president that the president need to put the state under the president's rule. But what happened was that certain things happened, and in the end, SR Bommai was able to form the government. But SR Bommai was not informed that the president's rule is going to be imposed. So, the governor did not ascertain the view of the CM, and president's rule was imposed. So, SR Bommai appealed first to the High Court, but after High Court, he appealed to the Supreme Court, and then Supreme Court referred it to the 9-judge bench. So, a 9-judge bench was constituted, and in the end, the 9-judge bench was of the opinion that the decision of the president and the basis for the decision of the president comes under judicial review. Now, regarding the verdict, so it was about that president's proclamation can be subject to judicial review. Whatever the proclamation president does, it comes under judicial review. एंड द ग्राउंड्स फॉर द जुडिशियल रिव्यू कैन बी इलीगैलिटी, मैलिफाइड, एक्सट्रेनियस कंसिडरेशंस, अब्यूज ऑफ पावर और फ्रॉड. इफ एनी ऑफ दीज ग्राउंड्स आर फाउंड देन देर कैन बी अ प्रॉब्लम फॉर द President's rule also, because the if under judicial review or any of the ground comes into the picture, then there can be problems. Then the material relied on for making the decision can be reviewed, and if the material on which the president relied for taking the decision of the president's rule comes under any of these grounds and is under the process of judicial review, that is when the problem starts to happen. And parliamentary approval necessary for imposing president's rule, this was also made mandatory. Parliamentary approval means that the president's rule needs to be approved by both the houses of the parliament, that is the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, within 2 months, maximum for a period of 3 years, in one go for a period of 6 months. After 6 months, then the approval from the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha or the parliament needs to be there. And the president has the power that whenever he or she deems fit, then the removal of the president's rule can also take place. Then it can also scrutinize the conduct of the governor's office. The role of the governor also came into the picture, and the point of governor's office and how the governor office works also was pointed out. So this was the verdict which came into the picture. So it was majorly the point of judicial review and the parliamentary approval necessary for imposing president's rule. And the significance of the S.R. Bhoomi verdict or the S.R. Bhoomi case was that after the S.R. Bhoomi verdict, the imposition of president's rule, the number of cases of president's rule became very, very low. It came to almost, you can say, minimum numbers were registered. So imposition of president's rule drastically decreased after the Bhoomi verdict. Drastically, it means that the numbers went down very rapidly. So between January 1950 and March 1994, president's rule was imposed 100 times, on an average of 2.5 times a year. While between 1995 and 2021, that is recently, it has been imposed only 29 times or a little more than once a year. So you can see the difference. Earlier it was more than 100 times and now it is only 29 times. So it means the S.R. Bhoomi case and the role regarding the judicial review that the president's rule or the actions that the president takes can come in under judicial review has played a major role in lowering down the cases of the president's rule. Now, regarding the Kashmir reference, the question which was raised was whether Article 370 could have been abrogated when the state was under president's rule. So it was said that if the state was under president's rule, whether the state was under president's rule, then Article 370 could have been abrogated or not. Whether it could be done, yes or no. So this was the question which was raised, that if president's rule is applied and if president's rule is going on, can the abrogation of Article 370 take place or not? So whether the president could give consent to the revocation of J&K's special status or not. So this was the question which was raised. And going by what has been done recently, the answer is yes. The Supreme Court relied on the Bhoomi ruling. So to answer these questions, the Supreme Court has given reference of the S.R. Bhoomi versus Union of India case and has said that the actions of the president are constitutionally valid. This is what the Supreme Court has said, and these are the words, that the president, that the actions of the president are constitutionally valid. Whatever has been done, the actions are constitutionally valid. It means through the constitution, whatever the president does can be validated. Now in the end, a mains practice question, and you people need to do your answer writing practice, and this is for 10 marks. And the command given here is discuss. There is a need for making changes to the constitution so as to stop the misuse of Article 356. As we just discussed in the reference phase also, that the drastic decrease of the use of Article 356. So, try to do your answer writing practice, and I don't think this would be a very difficult question for you. Write about Article 356, write about its constitutional provisions, how is it misused, what can be done to mitigate its misuse, and what can be the way forward. So, try to do your answer writing practice, and that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Till we meet next time, keep reading and keep writing.